morning, guys. How you doing? Thought I'd bring you guys along for another installation we're doing today. Heading out to do a package unit over in Carmichael. Lady called me up the other day and no heat call late in the season. And I went out there. I think I got some pictures I can show on this video. But the blower motor was all seized up. I noticed that the heat would turn on and everything, but then it turned off after a little while, so it was like overheating. And so that kind of raised my curiosity, so I went around and checked out the blower motor, and the blower motor was all seized up because the fins on the squirrel cages that spin around were literally broken. So that's a pretty nasty situation when that happens. I also checked out the heat exchanger just because the system was around 20 years old. You know, any system over 5-10 years old, you probably want to go ahead and check the heat exchanger just for a safety inspection. I'm glad I did on this call, because I found about a 2-inch crack in a kind of a underside seam where the metal bends, and just a real rusty looking nasty crack. So I went ahead and let her know about that. I found out that Lennox did have the heat exchanger, and they also had the squirrel cage. So I let her know that the parts were available. I let her know the price for the repairs. And I also let her know that I wasn't sure if the blower motor was still gonna work or not once I did get it up, because it was all seized up. I would have to get the flywheel on just to make sure to see if the blower motor was still working at that time. So that could be an additional charge. So being a 20-year-old system, I just let her make up her mind whether she wanted to repair it or replace it, give her the option. And she was like, well, you know, how much is a new system then, Greg? Because I don't think I'm going to spend, you know, that much money on repairs. So, and I completely agree. I don't think I would do the same. I think I would do the same thing. So we offer four types of financing. So I offered her one step. We weren't able to get through on that one. Just for some reason was declined. And then we were able to offer her financing through Y-Green. So she was able to finance the project through her property taxes that she pays every year. So just another way of getting a new system financed. So we're going to go out and do that install today. And I just kind of thought I'd bring you guys along. Always fun when we get a crane involved. So see if I can bring you guys along and show you some cool stuff today. So, all right. Thanks for watching.
What size you got? Charred up.
We always check the gas pressure on the roads. Here in California, our road tech support guy always tells us to set our gas pressure down to 3.25 here in this area, just since it's so mild. But it's good. We're at 3.4, 3.5. I'm gonna go ahead and just set it down to 3.3 and just leave it at that. We had to start doing that a lot out here in California because this gas valve would come at like 3.7, 3.8 sometimes. And we would always end up, you know, just installers would always end up leaving without setting the gas pressure, end up tripping the high limit, have to come out and set the gas pressure down to 3.25. So now on every job, that's just what we do. So I'm gonna do that right now. Set up. So we're gonna let this baby run. All done. Peace.